Welcome to another video about the Creality CR10S PRO, and today we're going to be talking about the CR10S PRO right after taking it out of the box, tuning, and what should you expect on GitHub. And this is where you can download the firmware for the Creality CR10S PRO. This is the firmware offered by Tiny 3D Machines, and the file is right here, CR10S PRO 119B5 hex. And this file, it's about 425 kilobytes. So basically, after unboxing the CR10S PRO, you should do a firmware update. So I will walk you through most of the follow-up changes as they depend on each other. So skipping one and doing it earlier rather than later might be counterproductive. So stay tuned. After the firmware update, you should tighten all the knobs that help with the bed leveling. Tighten them all completely until you cannot tighten them anymore. And this will make the bed very sturdy, so it won't shake side to side or back and forth as your y-axis is traveling back and forth trying to print something. In this manner, the wall print will be fine. In the bed leveling process, if your knobs here, okay, as they travel on the bed rails, if they spin while the bed travels, that means they're properly adjusted, okay, but they shouldn't be excessively tight. So basically, make sure that the wheel spins on the rail as you drag on the bed. Make sure they're all four are like that. And if you have one of them that you can hold it very lightly with your hand pressed on it and it doesn't spin on the rail, that means that it's not flush on the rail and the bed may be warped a little bit. So make sure that if that is the case, you use the wrench and you adjust the eccentric knots, like just slightly. As see, this has play here or give. I just do just a tiny bit. That's it. Okay, that's enough. Test again to see if the roller spins on the rail. Okay, and it may take a bit of time to actually dial it in properly, and dial it in slowly. Do not tighten one until you feel that it's already on the rail. Make sure that you tighten it a bit and then tighten the opposite one, and then tighten the laterally opposite one, and then the diagonally opposite one, and make sure that the bed doesn't have issues. If the bed is completely like loose, it will move up and down as you actually make the rollers grip the rails properly. So make sure the head doesn't have any rattle as it moves side to side. Like my head now, I tuned it and it has no rattle in it. However, when the printer came initially, this was rattling all over the place and it was dragging on the printer. I thought it's some sort of flexibility issue, but eventually I figured out that it wasn't supposed to be like this. The best way I found to tune or fine-tune the head is to take it completely off the x-axis rail. When you take it off the rail, you have access to the knobs and to the rollers behind. Basically, make sure that everything is in the correct position, as the eccentric knot or the offset knot will give you some problems and you will not completely eliminate the rattle in the head. So that was one of my major problems that I dealt with trying to fine-tune this printer. There's two screws behind this mask here, which are corresponding to two rollers in the back. You may want to take those screws, loosen them up, take this entire thing off the x-axis rail and put it in some sort of a soft vise, and then there you can make sure that you press down on the rollers as you tighten the screws, and you may gain a few hundredths of a millimeters downward. And then with the offset knot roller here in the backwards, as you move that upwards, you'll create pressure, perfect pressure, so the head doesn't rattle on this. And I did explain how to fine-tune the head before. It's quite of a trial and error process. There's three variables into the equation. You have the offset knot, which is the main eccentric knot, and then you have the Allen knot, and then you have the opposing knot. And that is a process. So if you have all the parts unmounted from the head, it will make your job easier. So in order to put the head back together, and especially to put the belt back together, please loosen these two knots here, and then take the Allen key, the thickest one, and put it in between. I led mine like this because I felt that this is the best, but you can twist the Allen. Mine doesn't twist, but if you twist the Allen key, you gain a few more thousandths of a millimeter or hundredths of a millimeter, and you put a little more tension on the belt. I feel if you put a lot more tension, it'll vibrate harder and maybe your print will have problems. You can press harder to the right, and then you tighten these with the other Allen keys and you have tension on the belt as you put the head back together. After you finished tuning or fine-tuning the head and making sure that there is no problems or rattling in the head, you should fine-tune and level the x-axis, okay? And you put your hands behind it and you swivel these flanges, I guess, left to right together, and make sure that the x-axis go up and down together, and measure with the 100 millimeter probe to the right and to the left and make sure that they fit at the same height. And after that, do a bed leveling and test again to see if the travel on the Z-axis has affected or altered how the X-axis stays like this. In the beginning, if you do not have enough patience, then you can just continue with it like that, but make sure that you do a pretty good job in the beginning. And then only after that, you should be concerned about leveling the bed. And leveling the bed is highly dependent also on the proximity probe. And with the firmware from TinyMachines, it will make sure that it always levels at the same time and you don't lose the leveling. Because with the other firmware, I always had to re-level the bed and it would always change its settings. To level the bed, you can do it manually, basically, okay? You can do this naturally and follow and see when the nozzle touches the bed or it's close to touching the bed. And I'm going to use the 0.2 millimeter probe, okay? And this probe is going to fit under the nozzle and it is just the slightest of drag. So basically what you have to do now that the knobs have been tightened, the leveling nuts, you move the bed with all the four corners, all right, and you move the nozzle to each corner and you test with the probe at each corner. Make sure that there is some sort of a clearance. Mine seems to still have it, but you have to also remember that the aluminum plate on the bed also has some sort of warpage in it, so that's a whole different story. And then try the center and make sure that you kind of compromise in between the center and the four corners if that doesn't work. And then from the menu with the TinyMachines firmware, it will hold the settings because it goes and measures the bed and it adjusts on the flight as it prints when you print, even if there's some portions where the bed may be warped or your aluminum plate may be warped, and that will adjust on the fly based on the settings, which will actually stick. So that's how you do a bed leveling. Only then you can do like the electronic bed leveling from the menu, tuning the gantry or the X-axis on the gantry. As you can see here, I have the wrench already on the eccentric or offset nut. And then the same way as with the bed, you only have to do it in small increments and make sure that when you press the wheel, as the x-axis travels up and down, make sure that the wheel spins as it travels up and down. And the same wire here, you use the wrench right here. My wrench has a lot of give in it, so basically use just like very small increments to make sure. And then once you rotate, if you try to rotate the wheel and if it doesn't work, that means it has grip on the rail, so it will stay on the rail properly. Okay, furthermore, it should have a little bit of give, so it should spin into place if you try hard enough. Okay, it shouldn't be completely tight because that means it's too tight and it will warp the gantry itself. And the last thing, if you have problems with the Z-axis, make sure that you check the T-nuts here, okay, as the Z-axis travels up and down, and as well as here, okay, in this area. And if the T-axis has issues, or if you feel bumps as you rotate the screws on the Z-axis up and down, and you feel bumps or humps or like speed ups as the X-axis travels up and down, then make sure that you have these T-nuts maintaining the screws all the way up close to the bracket that keeps them. If you remove the bracket and the bracket applies a lot of pressure to keep the screw in its proper position, and when you remove the bracket, you see that the screw is very, very far from the center of the bracket that is supposed to maintain the screws vertically, then that means it applies a lot of pressure on the T-nut, and the T-nut has to have some looseness to it. And you may have to loosen the screws right here to make sure they give a little give to the T-nut. However, if you give too much give to the T-nut, then the T-nut will travel up and down before it makes your entire X-axis travel up and down. So that is a bit of catch 20/20 there. Maybe sometimes you may have to actually bend this a little bit to have the T-nut stay properly in its place. And furthermore, we can do another trick. Okay, so if you still continue to have trouble with the T-nuts here and here, okay, you can dismount the motors and make sure that as the rod, as the screw travels vertically up, is vertical, and it maintains its vertical position at the top, close to where the center hole for the holding bracket with the ball bearing would be. Okay, and as you loosen this up, the motor can shift a little bit left to right, and as you tighten it, it will allow for the top of the screw rod to be close to the hole or to the center hole of the bracket. And you can do this for both of them. That will also further tune your Z-axis for your Creality CR10S Pro. And furthermore, there's special T-nuts that I saw online somebody purchased and has a whole YouTube video about the Creality CR10S Pro T-nuts, and you can watch his video. And probably with a quick search, you can find his video. I haven't changed my T-nuts yet. These are the variables that you need to keep in mind when you tune your Z-axis. I'll give you a tip, and there's a video on my settings, on the Cura settings, to get the best possible prints, especially in the exterior of walls.